Let's discuss the search operations for the Cessna plane in Isabela with Armed Forces spokesperson Colonel Medel Aguilar. We'll also talk to him about the military's efforts to monitor its personnel after some former soldiers were tagged in the killing of Negros Oriental Governor Ruel Degamo. Good morning, Colonel Aguilar, and thank you for joining us.
Good morning, Ms. Rica and Ms. Nikki. Good morning to your viewers also.
Thank you, Colonel. It's going to be a long day for the AFP, especially with the Cessna plane finally being found after 43 days. Would you be able to tell us any update with that, Colonel, knowing that the AFP has been helping with the search and retrieval operations?
Yes, we received a report yesterday about the finding of the missing Cessna plane. And Unfortunately, it was a composite group coming from the PCG, from the Makunakon Disaster Response Team, and other research units. Our troops is not in that place, so there is already a directive to divert the our troops there so that it can also assist.
Yes, we also learned
that it's the terrain is difficult, and it is thickly vegetated. Being a forest area, forested area, so it will take some time before the remains of the dead persons will be brought to where they should be.
Colonel, yesterday, from the press conference that was held, there still was no pictures of the wreckage, not even any idea yet of what happened. But it's been almost it's been hours after that. Do we have any idea of at least of how the plane was found, what it looked like, how were the bodies found, how far was it from the plane?
Probably the local government unit, DRRM teams can describe, because they were the ones who found the wreckage. So we leave it to them. I think they should be the one to give the pictures. For us, we'll just be ready to assist.
All right. Thank you for that, Colonel. It's been, because you understand, it's 43 days since we've been monitoring this. Now, let's move now to a different topic. For the military officials that were, they were previous military officials. They were found to have been involved in charges and incidents of violence. Now, the AFP is looking at different ways of how you'd be able to filter out previous army officials who are now involved in things like this. It's easy to adjust how we accept cadets, processes we do when we get them in. But how about for those dishonorably discharged, Colonel? What happens before the AFP sends them back home?
Most of the involved personnel are actually facing cases and went on a wound. And that's the reason that we didn't have control over these people. Now, the Philippine Army, being the force provider of the armed forces of the Philippines, one of the force providers, is now coming up with proactive measures that will be implemented, so that not just for the benefit of those who are retired retired from the service, but including those who were separated dishonorably, so that we can avoid incidents like this in the future.
Colonel, is there an assessment that happens when you discharge a soldier, a former soldier? Do you do some cross-check on the initial psychological profile?
The problem, ma'am, is that they went on a wound. So we cannot just subject them to psychological profiling, because we cannot, they are not within our custody. So what happens if they went on a wound is that they will be reported, they will be dropped from the roster of troops, and then they will be issued with orders discharging them from the service dishonorably. Now, many of those who went on a wound, of course, were facing other cases. So that's why they felt that they no longer can no longer serve the armed forces, and I think that's a reason why we cannot just subject them to profile, to psychological profile. But this time, the Army is coming up with proactive measures so that it will also benefit those who are dishonorably discharged.
Yeah, but let's say, Colonel, that on a different take, let's say on a different matter, rather, what if those involved did not go on a roll? What if their case was just heard, they were tried, and they were found guilty of? That's why they were being led to an honorable discharge. Is there a process for that?
Yes, of course, during the investigation, we keep them in custody, in our custody. And then they are subjected to military justice system. So, but when the orders of the discharge is published, so that's when that's the time when we release them. Now, if with this new measure that the Philippine Army will be pursuing, then while undergoing the trial or the general court martial or whatever it is, then there will also be some activities that will be implemented. Actually, the Army has already said that it will review the transition program, assistance program. This program is intended for the retiring personnel. Now, the Philippine Army is thinking of including the those who will be separated from the service because of the cases they are facing.
That's good to know, Colonel, because just last week, I think, or a week ago, retired AFP Chief of Staff Santiago said that it's easier to entice dishonored, discharged soldiers because they're not earning anything, because of them not being able to get jobs. Is this the reason why the AFP is suddenly thinking of ways to help alleviate their situation?
Yes, ma'am, because we have taught these people the skill that is very dangerous if used in crimes or in lawlessness. So I think it is also our responsibility to make sure that this skill sets that they have learned will not be used against our people, because probably this personnel have forgotten that the very reason of our existence in the armed forces of the Philippines is to protect our people. And therefore, we have to make sure that this remains with them even after their service.
Colonel, for elite soldiers, those who are really trained tactically, even on close combat fighting, do we have a threat analysis on those soldiers?
Ma'am, right now they are being they will be included in our monitoring even after they are separated from the service, especially those who are trained on or those we consider as members of the elite force. Right now, we only monitor the demolitionists, those who are good in skilled in bomb making or so that they cannot be used for terroristic activities. So this time we will be having a roster for those who are skilled, those who are assigned with elite forces, those with the special skills, so that they cannot also be used by the undesirable organizations.
This roster that you're mentioning, Colonel, is this of active soldiers on duty?
The active soldiers on duty are controlled
by the army, of course.
Yes.
But how do you go about getting a database for those you cannot control? I mean, those outside and dishonorably discharged or retired.
Ma'am, when you are dishonorably discharged, there is an order that is published. And usually the Philippine Army or the force providers, the Philippine Air Force, the Philippine Navy, keep a record of their personnel. So you will know, they should know who are those personnel who are separated dishonorably and those who possess these skill sets that are dangerous if used by criminal syndicates.
Of course, there's a shortage of personnel. It's not every day that we have a lot of people who would be able to help us out. But do we have at least someone, Colonel, who goes down the list and updating them as to how these people are doing, the status of their current lifestyle is?
There is a unit, an office, actually, ma'am, that is involved in the prosecution of these people. And there is also a staff officer that is in charge of the human resource. So they can work together. If there is a need to put up a special unit or office that will keep track of these of this dishonorably discharged personnel, but it would be for the major services to decide later on.
Mm-hmm. You mentioned earlier that the AFP is now doing a planning for things that they can, assistance they can give to personnel that will be dishonorably discharged. Do you have an idea of that at the moment, or how long will we be waiting for the general idea to surface?
We will be discussing that. It will take place at this, at the force provider level at the major services. And the Armed Forces of the Philippines will monitor that so that it will be implemented to effect the necessary changes or the desired to achieve the desired results that we have in mind.
All right. And with that, I will let you go. Thank you so much for your time, Colonel Aguilar. And you have a good morning ahead of you.
Thank you also, Ms. Rica, and a good morning.
Thank you. That was Colonel Miguel Aguilar reporter with us live this morning.